What's up, guys? Corey here. Getting ready to do a little bit of carpet stretching. It's going to be a hall. It's going to also incorporate part of a room. I'm going to stretch that. And then I've got another area that I'm going to, I can't really tell you. I just have to show you another area here in the upstairs, I guess, what, media room or playroom or something here. Let me turn the camera around and show you where I'm starting. All right, now right here, I'm going to do basically a hallway type stretch here. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to probably right about, I don't want to do it in the doorway so much, so probably right about here, I'm going to cut the carpet open somewhere here, then stretch them together with my seam stretchers here. I really like these guys a lot. And again, you know, what I preach on my channel is to never buy new, and none of this is new. Those are really expensive when bought new. I bought both of those for $150 a piece in pawn shops. So if you're following this channel, you'll never hear me tell you to go out and buy something brand new. You'll never hear that. So over here, I'm going to be, it's obviously a used head off of a crane power stretcher. I'm going to stretch this area here with my Triforce attachment that I like so much. So basically, I'm going to probably go over there and I'm going to cut. And this is going to be very, very simple to do. Over here, this is interesting to watch. I don't know if anybody's interested in, you know, learning hall stretching or anything like that, but this is a darn good place to do it here. All right, guys, got my sunshades turned around in carpet stretching mode, getting ready to cut some carpet here, so I'll be right back. All right, a little update here. Carpet cut, and I actually did cut it right on the edge of the door, so I didn't create some little issue that I didn't really feel like messing with this time of day. All right. So this guy is just basically sitting here waiting. What I'm gonna do now, the next step usually is, since I'm upstairs, it's more favorable. I can put nails in this, and the stay nails will hold it in place, and I can take the seam stretchers out of my way and then get to my seam a lot easier. Over here, I set up this guy so we can have a look at this power stretcher. Now this power stretcher creaks because it's very old. So don't necessarily think all the creaking is for me really hammering down on it so much. It's just, it's a really old power stretcher. I paid $80 for it. Got the poles at the house. So let me set this up here. And then we will go stretch that kind of quickly here. See how this is gonna work. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take up the carpet along the edge of the walls, across, and down to here, and then over here, and right over here, I'll make little relief cuts. So I can stretch it, and then you'll see it like right over in the areas right here, and right there, it'll bubble up a little bit. So here we go. All right, now if you're a carpet guy, you'll realize that this piece here is seamed in right there. So my stretch the success of my stretch is strongly dependent on the quality of that seam. So if I bust it, I create more work for myself. If not, that'd be great. So here we go. Get my stair tool. I can find it. Never been exactly sure why they call this a stair tool. You know, I was a phone guy before this whole carpet thing came around. This carpet is very, 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 very thin and very cheap. So I'm gonna do another little stretch here, another little stretch here. You can't always, if you don't know a lot about carpet and you start, the house is not necessarily an indication that it will have high quality carpet in it. A lot of times some of the bigger, more expensive homes, when it gets time to put flooring in, is where people cut corners. So sometimes you'll find the cheapest carpeting in the most expensive homes. All right, now I got the carpet all captured right here. This is what I took off it. Basically, all there is to do now is to tuck it in all along here. Over here, lift this guy up right here, retuck all of this in. And I'll show that here when I get finished up. I'm gonna fire my irons up here and warm them up and get ready to mess with this guy here. I just wanted to show the Triforce, because the people at Triforce liked me and my channel enough to send this to me to profile it on my channel. So I really appreciate those guys, because they have a really small mom and pop business that makes tools for guys like me. Probably run into is that when carpet guys learn to do their work with a certain type of tool, they almost never deviate. So hopefully through time I'll be able to help people realize there's an easier way to do things than connecting poles and doing everything that you've done. You just have to think outside the box a little bit. All right, guys, I'm gonna do a little bit of work and then I will check back in shortly. All right, doing an update here. This guy is all done with here. Stretched in just fine. Now, here, I'm putting this guy back together. You see the arrangement, I've got the nails in here. Kind of hard to see when you take the stretchers off. kick one of those nails, it hurts sometimes. Careful not to step on the nails. And then this is how much shorter the carpet is. It's very elastic, this carpet, so very stretchy. So I will show this when I'm complete. All right, we are all finished finally. And this took a little longer than it really should have, because for some reason it wasn't, I don't know what happened, but while I was seaming this together, from about here where you can see it's still wet right there, from about there to there, it opened up and the fibers fell through and stuck to the carpet tape. So I had to steam it back open, pull everything off the tape, which was really difficult because it bonds terribly strong this way when you seam it slowly from the top. Finally managed to pull the fibers out of there, retrim everything, and then do it again halfway across. So, you know, being that you work in carpet repair, you can repair your own little issues that you have along the way, which is a darn good trait to have in this business here. That is all stretched out too. All right, guys, that actually completes my day. I'm gonna stand under this fan here so I can dry off a little bit before I go out there in that 110% humidity again. All right, guys, I had three tomorrow. One of them rescheduled, thank God. If there's anybody local here in town that does carpet repair here in Austin, Texas, if you can provide like some reviews or something for me, or show me your work or something, I'm okay sending you work. But for me to be comfortable doing that, I need to see reviews. So please, also if you clean carpet as well in Austin, Texas, I don't mind if you clean with steam or VLM or whatever you do, as long as you do a good job. I'm only one person. I'm not going to grow this business. It's just one person. That's me. That's all I'll ever be. If you would like me to send you work, call up, introduce yourself. I don't mind sharing. It's all good karma. It's a good trait to have. Good karma. All right, guys. I appreciate you watching. God bless.